and disappeared into the valley hundreds of feet below. But the Saint Bernard, still pulling carefully and gently by himself, was next busily licking the boy's white face and breathing his heat upon him, when help arrived with the brandy and the blankets. I believe it was the tireless and incessant attentions of that great dog that really saved the life, for he lay upon the form with his whole body, keeping him warm, and letting go only when he understood that the blankets and our arms, carrying him to the chalet, might replace own self-sacrificing love.
"I heard a voice crying outside the door in the wind,"
she told me afterward.
"It was his voice, you see, and it called me by name. I don't know what guided me to the place, for I think I shut my eyes the whole way till I fell at his side."
B-24 by Arthur Conan Doyle. I told my story when I was taken, and no one would listen to me. Then I told it again at the trial, the whole thing absolutely as it happened, without so much as a word added. I said it all out truly, so help me God, all that Lady Mannering said and did, and then all that I had said and done, just as it occurred. And what did I get for it? The prisoner put forward a rambling and inconsequential statement, incredible in its details and supported by any shred of corroborative evidence. That was what one of the London papers said. And others let it pass as if I had made no defense at all. And yet, with my own eyes, I saw Lord Mannering murdered. And I am as guiltless of it as any man on the jury that tried me. Now, sir, you are there to receive the petitions of prisoners. It all lies with you. All I ask is that you read it. Just read it. And then that you make an inquiry or two about the private character of this Lady Mannering. If she still keeps the name that she had 3 years ago, when to my sorrow and ruin I came to meet her. You could use a private inquiry agent or a good lawyer, and you would soon learn enough to show you that my story is the true one.